Hello kids, in today's video we will be discussing about looping control structure. So far we have discussed what is if else and nested if and then switch case. Now we will be learning about looping control structure, which are for loop, while loop and do while loop. And in this video we will be discussing about for loop. So, a loop is a sequence of instructions that is continually repeated until specified condition becomes true. That is, a looping control structure means it is a set of sequence or instructions that will be repeated until and unless a condition is true, it repeats, and when it becomes false, it just stops. Okay, that is known as loop. And the repetition of the code until the condition becomes false is terminated as iteration. So iteration means the term which we give for the repetition of the code is known as iteration. Now we will see what are the looping parts. A loop control structure contains the following parts. First one is control variable. It is a variable which contains initial value to determine the duration of repetitions. So control variable, it is a variable which contains the initial value. For example, like if you wanted to count 10 times or walk 10 times, we will be having counting, isn't it? Like number 1, when we walk from one side to the other side, we will count 1. Again, from there till here, again 2. Like that, if you wanted to do any thing which is repeatedly doing, first we will be having a initial value, from there we will be starting. Like if you wanted to count from 10, 10 will be the initial value. Counting from 1 to 10, then 1 will be the initial value. So there will be a control variable which contains the initial value from where the repetition should start with. The next is body of the loop. So it is a set of statements which are executed within the loop simultaneously. So there is body of the loop means there will be a counter variable, and what has to be repeated that will be written inside the body of the loop. So we will be counting. So somebody, for example, if you are keeping a running race from one point to the other, the person will be running and the other person will be counting. Okay, so running is the body of the loop. And next is test condition. So every loop contains a test condition which checks whether the loop has to be repeated or terminated. Depending on the condition, control enters into the body of the loop and executes till the condition becomes false. So there will be a test condition. So computer does not have a brain, isn't it? So computer cannot, like if he wanted to do a set of instructions 10 times, computer cannot count exactly 10 times and cannot stop. So we need to apply a test condition. So computer will every now and then check the test condition, and until the test condition becomes true, it repeats, and when it becomes false, it stops. So the test condition is again another part of a looping structure. The next is a step value. It determines the increment or decrement of the control variable unless the test condition becomes false. So step value means first initial value we have told, then second is body of the loop also we have determined, then next is condition. So like if we wanted to repeat 1 to 10 times, after 1 we have to increment the value by 1, so it will become 2. Again, from 2 we have to increase the value by 1, so again it becomes 3, and again it becomes 4. Like that we have to increment the value by 1 so that it can count, we can count, isn't it? Same way we need to have a step value. Sometimes step value will be only incrementing by 1, sometimes incrementing by 2. So if 1 is there, then again when we are incrementing the value by 2, it becomes 3, then it becomes 5, like that. So step value, it determines the increment or decrement. Not only increment, decrement also. We can even decrease. Like if you wanted to count from 1 to 10, even you can count from 10 to 1 also. Then also it is counting 10 times. So even we can have even increment as well as decrement also. let us see what is for loop. So for loop is used to repeat a particular task for finite number of times. So for loop, again, for loop, while loop or do while loop, all of the three loops, it does the same thing. That is, repeat a particular task for a number of times. And the for loop will repeat a particular task for finite number of times. That means the fixed number of times. Like if we know the loop has to be repeated for 10 times, then we can use this for loop. And for loop is also called an entry controlled loop because the body of the loop is executed only after the condition evaluates to true. So for loop is called as an entry controlled loop, and it is because the body of the loop is executed only after the condition is true. So first is a initialization expression, that is we need to know from where it has to start. Then we will check the condition, and if the condition is true, only it comes inside and it will execute the loop. Suppose if the condition is false, it will not get inside the block of statements, or it will not execute the loop. So we'll see the syntax. So for initialization expression, semicolon, conditional expression, semicolon, increment or decrement, that everything inside the bracket. So for initialization expression is the expression from where we start the loop. For example, if we are starting the loop from the 1, then initialization expression will be I is equal to 1. We need to give like we cannot simply give 1, we have to initialize it with a variable, so I is equal to 1. The next is conditional expression. So conditional expression means till, like what is the condition to be executed, till where the loop has to be repeated. Such kind of conditions we can give it in the conditional expression. Next is the step value or increment or decrement values, like the whether it has to be incremented with one value or two value or three value, like that we can mention here. The next is inside the block there is Java statements. So this is a basic syntax of for loop. Now we will see how it is working of for loop. So initialization expression is initialized only once at the beginning of the for loop. So inside the for loop, first statement was initialization expression, and that will be running only once at the beginning of the loop. The next is the test expression is evaluated. So if the condition is true, then the body of the loop will be executed. So test expression means the what is the condition, that condition will be checked secondly. Then if it is true, then it comes inside and body of the loop will be executed. Then next, after the loop is executed, after every statement in the loop is executed, it comes when it reaches the end of the block, that is a closing bracket, then it goes back to the for loop, and the third expression, that is increment or decrement operation, will be executed. So first initialization expression, that is that will happen only for once. The next expression is the test expression, I mean conditional expression, that will be executed. Then thirdly, it comes inside the loop and it will execute the statements, block of statements written inside the loop. And when it see a closing bracket, the control goes back to the for loop again, for statement again. And inside that, the third parameter, that is increment or decrement expression, will be executed. The next, it will check for the conditional expression. So at any point of time, when the conditional expression becomes false, the loop will terminate and will stop. So next thing is, we will the computer will check, or the compiler will check the conditional expression. And again, if it is true, it executes a block of statement. Again, when it see a closing bracket, it goes to the increment and decrement value. Again, it executes like a circle. So until and unless a conditional expression becomes false, the loop will terminate. The next, the control of the execution moves to the statement following the loop if there is any, like if it is false, like control, if in the previous statement it is told that it will stop, right? So if at all any statements are written down to the for loop, that will be executed like a normal flow. I hope the working of for loop is clear. Now I will explain the same with an example so it will be more clear. So let us see the example. So this is a small program based on the for loop. So here class name is numbers. So here in this program we will be printing numbers from 1 to 10. Here public static void main, then int I, then for loop is here. So in the for loop we have three parameters. One is initialization statement, that is I is equal to 1. The next is I less than or equal to 10, which is a condition statement. The next is I plus plus, which is a increment or decrement, that is step value. So first thing is the compiler will take us I is equal to 1 inside the for loop, that will be repeated only once, okay, and I is equal to 1. Then the second step is I less than or equal to 10 will be checked. So I value is 1. So 1 is less than or equal to 10 will be checked. The condition is true. So once a condition is true, it comes inside the loop. So loop means the block of statements which is written inside the brackets. Okay, opening and closing braces. Inside that we have only one statement here, that is system.out.println statement. So what is written inside the println is I. So I value will be printed, that is 1 will be printed. Then again, once that statement is printed, there is nothing to execute inside the for loop. So the third part of the for loop, that is I plus plus, will be initiated. So that means I value is 1, so 1 plus plus, that is 2. So again, next step is it checks a condition, that is whether I is less than or equal to 10. So what is the I value now? It is 2. So 2 is less than or equal to 10 will be checked. And since a condition is true, it comes inside and it prints a value I, that is 2. Again, I plus plus will be initiated. So I value will become 3 now, because 2 plus plus is 3. So 2 less than or equal to 10, it prints a value 2. Then again, it just goes on and it will print 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And when the I value, when the value becomes 10, 10 is less than or equal to 10 will be checked. 10 is equal to 10, the condition is again true. Then again, I plus plus will be initiated. I value will become 11. So 11 is less than or equal to 10. The condition is false, isn't it? 11 is not less than or 11 is not equal to 10. So condition is false. So the program stops. So let us now check what is the output. Right click, void main. So here you can see that numbers from 1 to 10 has got printed. Let us again check another example, even numbers. So here we are going to print numbers, even numbers from 2 to 20. So even numbers existing from 2 to 20 will be printed. So the for loop here mentioned is for I is equal to 2, I less than or equal to 20, I plus is equal to 2. So I is starting its value from 2 because the even numbers are starting from 2. So directly I have taken I is equal to 2. Then I should go till 20 because our agenda or our output should be the numbers from 2 to 20. So the limit is 20. Then I plus is equal to 2. So I value should increment its value by 2. Then we will get 2 plus 2, 4. 4 plus 2, 6. 6 plus 2, 8. Okay. So I think the for loop is clear now. Then again, we are printing the value of I. So working again same like the previous program, I is initiated to, that will be repeated only once. Then condition will be checked, that is 2 is less than or equal to 20 will be checked. If the condition is true, that is 2 is less than or equal to 20, condition is true, so it comes inside and it will print 2. Then again I plus is equal to 2 will be initiated. That means I plus is equal to 2 means I is equal to I plus 2. Okay, so I value will become the old I value plus 2. So old I value is 2, 2 plus 2, it becomes 4. So 4 less than or equal to 20, condition is true, it prints 4. Then again I plus is equal to 2 will be initiated. So then 4 plus 2 is equal to 6. So again condition will be checked whether 6 is less than or equal to 20. Condition is true, so it prints 6. So like that 2, 4, 6, 8, like that till 20 it gets printed. So again 20 less than or equal to 20. In that condition 20 is equal to 20 is satisfied. So again I value will be incremented to 2. So I value will become 22. So again condition will be checked whether 22 is less than or equal to 20. The condition is false and so the program stops. So we will check the output void main. So here you have seen that 2 to 20 has been printed, that is even numbers from 2 to 20. So with this your today's session is completed and this chapter is very important, as I used to say. It is very important, and study well, go through the video twice or thrice to make it more clear. Thank you.